In this video, I'll be going through how to stake your ADA on your Ledger device. So one of these cool little things, these Ledger Nanos or Ledger S or Ledger whatever it is, whatever model you have, it's really easy to start delegating from their app itself, the Ledger Live app, or you can actually restore your Ledger accounts in a Cardano native wallet. And I think that's by far the easiest way because you have a lot more flexibility around it. But if you are staking a whole bunch of different assets on the Ledger, it's kind of good to have it all on that Ledger Live app. Now, this all came about from a question from a delegate that is staking to our own stake pool, ADA Oz, and it reads, "Hello, I've been delegating my ADA to ADA Oz through Yoroi. I'm going to move over to Cardano staking options on Ledger Live. I would like to keep supporting ADA Oz as a fellow Australian, but there is no option to select this pool from the list provided on Ledger. Am I missing something here?" Okay, so it is a little bit confusing when you're going through the Ledger app and trying to find all these aspects to actually start delegating and staking your ADA, but let me go through that for you. So first off, really good idea to move your crypto assets to a hardware device. It really helps secure those assets. Using a hot wallet or a light wallet can be compromised quite easily, especially if you're storing your seed phrase online. Please don't do that. That's the same with a Ledger device. Store it offline on a piece of paper, a piece of metal, whatever it is. So this is what I use here. It's a piece of aluminium that you can pick up from Bunnings as cheap as $2 or something for a strip. And then you can cut that down. You have multiple different seed phrases and you can engrave it or boss it, whatever you want. Really easy way to store your seed phrase. And it's better than a piece of paper because you can easily lose that piece of paper. You can burn it. Someone will throw it out. And of course, there's lots of different hardware options when storing your crypto assets, not just the Ledger. You got Trezor as well. You can also get these really cool cards from Tangem. And their NFC chip in here allows you to unlock your crypto assets from your mobile device. And it's the only way to unlock it, sign and transfer assets. You need that physical device. And then the other one that I do have a review for as well is the Keystone, brand new Keystone device. This is a hardware wallet with LCD touchscreen, really cool thing there. And they also custom brand it as well. So you can see this one here, it's custom branded with my Wapus. Nice little touch there from the team, and check out the links in the show notes or the link above for the video review of that one. So back to the Ledger device. So let's load up the Ledger Live app. If you're already delegated to a particular stake pool, you will see this option here for stake already disabled because you have already delegated. But if you scroll down a little bit further down here, you can see those details of where you're delegated to. Here I'm delegated to Berry Pool. And then if you want to change that or delegate to a different pool, click on those little three dots there, the ellipses, and then click on change delegation. From here, you'll see the options to delegate, and automatically it comes up with the Ledger stake pool. And you can see here at the commission, that's 6%. So that means how much ADA fees they take every epoch. So it's 6% of the entire delegation of that particular pool. Now under that, you can also click on show all, and this will give you a list of all the stake pools that are currently operating in the Cardano ecosystem. Now there are a lot of stake pools. Now you can scroll through all these lists of pools endlessly trying to find which one you want to delegate to. But if you type in here in the search bar and you want to delegate directly to ADA Oz, just type in ADA OZ. And this is our pool here, ADA Oz Australia. So if you're in Australia and like to help support a fellow Australian stake pool operator, click on that, type that in, click on that. And you can see here our commission is just 1%. So we're going to take a 1% fee across the top, and you can simply click, hit continue, and then this will take you through the prompts to start delegating to the pool itself. Okay, so let's go through these prompts. First off, you need to actually go through and log into and activate the Cardano app on your Ledger device. So here I have the Ledger device, I've entered in the PIN, and now I can actually open it itself. And you can see Cardano is now ready. So on my screen here, I can then click on continue and then follow the prompts to continue with the delegation itself. So here now I can see it's starting a new ordinary transaction. So click on yes. I can see the transaction fee, which is 0.2 ADA. I'm delegating to the particular stake pool, and that's the ID of the stake pool, as long as it matches what's on screen. So I'm just checking the last few characters there, 5ZE. Yep, that looks good. Stake key, that's my own stake key. Then I can confirm that delegation itself. confirm the transaction, and away we go. So now we can see that transaction has been broadcasted, and I have now successfully delegated my wallet here, my Ledger wallet, to the ADA Oz state pool. Real quick, real easy, absolutely love what the team have done there to make that process really easy in the Ledger Live app itself. So going back to the original email, it did state that they're moving from Yoroi over to Ledger Live. Now with Yoroi and almost every single Cardano wallet out there, you still do have the option to delegate using your hardware device on that wallet. And I'll show you how to do it on Yoroi itself. Now here we are with Yoroi open, and if you click on wallet, you have the option to create a new one, restore existing one, or connect that hardware wallet. Click on connect hardware wallet, choose Cardano, and here we have the option to start loading in the Ledger hardware wallet itself. Click on that and follow the prompts and steps to go through and start loading up your Ledger wallet. So here I'll click on next and then follow the prompts here to connect my wallet. I'm using a Ledger Nano S. A prompt will come up and then we just go through and start exporting the various keys that we need from the Ledger device onto the wallet. There we go, so that's ready. I'll click on save. And now it's preparing the wallet and loading it up for me to start staking or doing anything else I want. That's it. That was really incredibly fast. So now in Yoroi, I'll click on staking from the left-hand side. And here you can see this wallet's already delegated to the ADA Oz state pool. But further down here, I can now start searching for a brand new one. I can go through the massive list again of all the pools or type in the pool ticker, in this case, ADA Oz. So there it is. I can type in my pool ticker, ADA Oz, and you can see my pool appear in that list. But as you can see, I'm already delegated, so I can't delegate again, but you can click on that button if you're not delegated and start following the prompts and delegate to that particular stake pool. Now, the other thing you might want to do is actually move all of your ADA assets from that hot wallet that you previously had in Yoroi or whatever wallet it was over to your Ledger device. And that is also really easy to do. So I'll load up my Ledger device again here. And you need to get your receiving address. So from the left-hand side here, I can click on receive, click on continue, and there it will give you one of your ADA addresses from your device. And then you can copy that and use that address back in Yoroi or whatever other wallet you are using to be able to transfer to. So now I can copy that address and then go back to my other wallet, such as Yoroi or even an exchange wallet, and then paste this in and then send ADA to it. So now I can go to another wallet such as Eternal and then click on send, paste in the address that I want to send to, which is my Ledger address, which I just received before, and send over ADA or any other Cardano native token or even NFTs directly to my Ledger device. Now, if you're unsure and it's your first time ever doing this and you have a considerable amount of assets that you want to move, send over a small test amount first. So here you can see I'm just sending in one ADA just to test it out. I'm just going to see how it all works, get comfortable with the process before sending a lot more assets over afterwards. So once you've sent all of your assets over to your Ledger device, you can start delegating that ADA. Now, if you're sending more assets, if you're DCAing from an exchange and you're sending it over back to that address that you received before, the ADA that you've just sent will automatically be staked to the stake pool that you're already delegated to. It's a really cool mechanism. It's really fluid. Absolutely love how Cardano staking works with how dynamic and fluid it is and gives you full control of your assets at any point in time. Hopefully this video tutorial has really helped you in regards to understanding how to move your assets and get started staking with a hardware device. I've given you a couple of options there as well with other hardware devices that you can start investigating. Check out the links in the show notes down below. They will lead to all the other hardware devices and other ways and other methods of staking the Cardano ecosystem. If you like this content, if you enjoyed this video, give me that thumbs up, click subscribe, click the notification bell. Lots more Cardano related content coming for you, and I'll see you in the next video. Yeah, gotta do it like that. You've been listening to the Learn Cardano podcast. Gotta get it hype. Crypto is what we like, but this is not investment or financial advice. Gotta do your research because it's risky. We know it is. This show is educational and it's informative. Crypto's the future, really. It ain't no debate.